We are going to add Google Analytics to your website. It's really easy, so just follow along with this step-by-step tutorial. Go to google.com/analytics and press enter. Then we are here at the Google Marketing Platform. Press over here, get started today. Then we need to sign in with Google. If you don't want to use your personal account and you want to create a new account, then we just press over here, create account. And then we're gonna use for personal use or for work or my business. If you already have a Google account, just type in your email over there, fill in your password and click on next. Then I need to use my security key because, well, you have to be safe. Then we press on next. Then we need to create an account. Now, this is not the name of your website. Within this Google Analytics account, you can add multiple websites. So just choose an account name that you can recognize, my personal websites, for example. Then we scroll down and here we can choose what kind of data we will be sharing with Google itself. And all these data sharing settings are mandatory by law to give you the most control about your data on your website. But what you want to do is you want to have this data being shared with other Google products and services. For example, if you want to use Google Signals, if you want to use Google Advertisement, you can also connect them later on, but why not do it right now? So select all of these things and then we press next. Then we're going to create a property. Within a property, you can add multiple websites or apps to measure. So for example, this property can be about the WordPress doctor websites or apps, whatever you have. Then we're going to change the time zone, which is very important because you want to know when your audience is on your websites. You want to know that because then you can advertise or send email campaigns at the right time. Very important information. If you say, well, my audience is not local, but worldwide, then you should use your own local time zone. In this case, I'm going with the United States Los Angeles time. And choose your currency is currently on US dollar, which is great. We press next. Then we're going to describe our business. Now, it's partly because they want to benchmark it, but most of the time, it's just because they want to sell Google AdWords to you so they can send you free vouchers so you can put some more ads on Google. They have to make some money some way. Then we're going to select the industry category that is closest to your business. In our case, I'm with jobs and education because I educate people about this. Then choose your business size. I am a small, I'm just me. Press next. Then we are going to choose our business objectives. This is important because then Google Analytics can customize reports for your business. So that's very nice. What do you want to do? Well, if you have an e-commerce website, select sales, of course. If you just have a business website and you want to track, for example, your forms or buttons pressed on your website like Call Me, very interesting, then use leads. If you just want to measure traffic and you're not so interested in leads, could be, then just select this one. And then last, we also have user engagement and retention. So this way we can see when do they click, when do they scroll, and all these times can be measured in this way. If you don't know what to use, you can also check this one, other multiple types of reports, and then everything will be measured for you. On my websites, I just want to track leads, traffic, and user engagement because I don't sell anything on my website yet. Press create. Then, of course, we need to accept the Google Analytics Terms of Service Agreement. Now, if you want to read this, be my guest, it is very big. But basically, if you don't agree to this, then you cannot use Google Analytics. It's just like that. So I'm going to accept it. Then we scroll down and we have another one. Additional terms applicable to data shared with Google. Then, of course, you also need to accept those ones and press on accept. Now we can start collecting our data. Do you want to measure a website, an Android app or an iOS app? In our case, I'm going to show you how to measure your website. So we click on web. Then we're going to fill in our website URL over there. WordPressDoctor.com. And then we need to give our stream a name so we can recognize it. So this will be the website WordPress. Just fill in your brand name over there. Now, enhanced measurement is already enabled because of the settings we previously entered. But if you click on this gear icon, do you want to capture scrolls, outbound clicks? Do you want to capture your site search, form interactions, video engagement, file downloads? All these things, yes, we want to measure those. If you click on Show Advanced Settings, we see that the search term query parameter has already been inserted there, which is the correct one if you're using a WordPress website. Every WordPress website uses the S in the URL if someone searches on your website, which is very valuable information because it shows us that, hey, something on our website is not clear enough, people cannot find it. So this way, using Google Analytics, we can actually improve our website. Then we click on Save over there and we press on Create and Continue. Just wait a second while Google loads everything in. And then we see the Google tag. This code makes sure that a script will be loaded in from the Google server to track everything that's going on your website. But this is the manual installation. We don't need this manual script if you're using a platform like WordPress, Shopify, Squarespace, Wix, or even Drupal. No. If you use one of these platforms, click over here, install with a CMS or website builder. Click on it, and we go to press on next. Then we click over here on the Monster Insights plugin, which I really don't advise you to use on your WordPress website because I really don't like it. It slows everything down. You can watch my tutorial over here and I'll show you 7 plugins that you really need to avoid. And one of them is Monster Insights plugin. Then just select the platform you're using over here. If you're using Wix, just click on Wix and you can see what you need to do over here. I'm not going to show you because this channel is not about Wix websites. If you're using Squarespace, again, all the instructions are over here. I'm not going to show you because I'm not a Squarespace channel. No, we are going to go with WordPress, and to do that, we're going to use the SiteKit plugin because that one is from Google itself. So click on it. And then keep this tab open and log into your WordPress website. If you're still logging in using WP Admin,
No!
Not a very safe way, so please watch my tutorial over there about securing your WordPress website because you really don't want to get hacked. Yes, I've installed multiple layers of security. Then on your dashboard, we go over here to Plugins, Add New Plugin. Then we go to the right side and we type in SiteKit. And there we are, SiteKit by Google, press install now. Then we click on activate. Congratulations, the SiteKit plugin is now active. Click on start setup. Then of course we want to connect Google Analytics as part of our setup, check this box. And then we click on this green button, sign in with Google. Then choose the account we have just used to set up Google Analytics. Here we go, press continue. And then we need to select all of it or else nothing will work. We scroll down and we press on continue. Then Google needs to verify it, so we click on verify. Then we need to turn on the metrics, so we press on allow. And then SiteKit also needs to set up Search Console, which is great. I've also created a tutorial over here and I can show you exactly step by step everything there is to know about this powerful tool called the Google Search Console. Very interesting. We press setup. And then we press on next. Here we go. Now it's connecting our service. We only need to select the right account. So click on this one and choose your account, my personal websites. Check the right property, in our case, WPress Doctor websites. And then the right data stream, which is website WPress Doctor. Perfect. The last button to press is complete setup. Well done, Google Analytics has been added to your WordPress website. Press on OK, got it. It can take up to 72 hours before you can see something happening inside of this dashboard or in your Google Analytics dedicated dashboard online. And the last thing to do is go over here and press test installation. I was going to test our Google Tag installation to see if everything works properly. Well done, your Google Tag was correctly detected on your website. And then we press on done over there. Well done, everything has been set up correctly. Now remember, it can take 48 to 72 hours before Google Analytics see the details of your website. So we click on this close button over there. Then we press on next. And now our data collection is pending because we need visitors to collect some data. Click on Continue to Home. And now we are at the dashboard of Google Analytics. If you also want to see an in-depth tutorial about Google Analytics and how to get some reports that are actually actionable for your website, drop it down in the comments. And if there's enough of them, I will make sure to make a good tutorial about that one. For now, hit that like button if I helped you out. Subscribe to the channel if you want to learn more about marketing, SEO, WordPress, Google services. It's all in there. I'd love to see you in this next video, which is also really amazing.